Welcome back friends. In this video we are going to discuss about for loop and control statements, which means in the last video we have discussed about if condition. So in this video we have a clear idea about the for loop and how we can return the for loop in a number of ways. We'll have a clear idea in this video. So first of all guys, those who want to transform their career into data science, make sure that you watch this video till the end. Definitely it is going to help you. Okay, I am opening my Jupyter notebook and I am writing some code regarding the for loop, so you will have a better idea. So I am opening my Jupyter notebook. So here is the for loop. So guys, for loop is the one which works with the help of index values only. Okay, so if I want to run the number from 1 to 100, for example I want to print the output in a single line from 1 to 100. So instead of writing a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2, c is equal to 3, d is equal to 4, so instead of writing n number of variables and printing that n number of variables, we can have a single statement known as a for loop statement. So how the for loop statement get worked in this particular video, we will have a clear idea. The syntax of the for loop statement is for I in range. So in the previous videos we have a clear idea about how the range function get worked. So range function get worked with the help of the starting position, which means either it may be 1 or it may be 0, it depending upon the user input, from the starting position, which means starting position to last position, but with the help of minus one category. Okay, this is how the range function get worked. So if I want to run, if I want to print 100 inputs, okay, from 1 to 100, I want to print each and every number. Instead of writing a is equal to 1 like this, I can write a for loop and I can easily print the numbers for I in range of 1 to 100. Okay, and I am just writing print condition. Okay, so we'll have a clear idea here. So what will be the first I value? Okay, I value will be 0, because for I and in range we are giving the range function. Range function starting from 1 to and we are printing from 1 to 100. This is the user input. Suppose you can also give from 0 to 100 or 2 to 100 or 3 to 100 depending upon the user requirement. Suppose I am giving from 0, I just want to print the values from 0 to 100. Okay, but the output will be 0 to 99 only, because the range function get worked with the help of n minus 1 category. Okay, here what is the n? 100. So 100 minus 1, which means 99 will be printed. Okay, if I exit this cell, so instead of printing vertically, which means parallelly, I want to print it in horizontal way. I just give a comma variable here and end is the keyword. See, it will be like this. Okay, so it is get starting from 0 and is reaching to 99. Because why it is only printing 99? Because we are the for loop, which means the range function get worked with the help of 100 minus 1, which means n minus 1 category. So for examples, in the particular exam, in this range function only, if I want to print from 5 to 100, instead of giving 100, I can give 101, because 101 minus 1, 100. So if I execute this cell, see, from the 5 to 100, it will print successfully. So here, see here, in another example, for I in range of 5, which means instead of giving the starting position 0 to 5, if you print here, see, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 is printed successfully. Because why 5 is not printed? We know that n minus 1 category will be followed by range function. So it is not printing 5th category. So if you want to print the 5th value in the output, instead of giving 6, you can give 5. Because 6 minus 1 is 5. See, the output, the 5 value printed in the output successfully. So there is no need of giving 2 parameters. So in the particular cells we can also give only single parameter also. So this how we can see in this particular video, for I in range of, if I just want to print 20 values, I am giving 20. So if I am executing it, print I, so instead of giving print I can also give, see, it starts from zero. If you just, if you pass only one parameter in the range function, it gets started from zero and it ends at the position of 19, because what is the n value here? 20, and it follows the category known as an n minus 1. So 20 minus 1, what is n minus 1 category, which means 20 minus 1, which means 19. Okay, this is how the range function get work. So instead of giving two parameters, if you pass one parameter only, automatically the compiler will recognize the user want to print from the zero. So if you want to print from 5, you can pass a parameter 5 and a comma operator. See if you execute it. So from 5 to 19 values it will generate it. So instead of printing 19, if you want to print 20 also, so just write here 21, execute it. See, it starts from 5 to 20. Okay, this is how the range function get worked. So the for loop also will be very easy, there is no issue. So see here, it is another example, best example for you. So instead of giving this big variable name, I'm just passing a, yeah. So see here, a is equal to 1 2 3, which means it is an array, and it is also an array, and it is also an array, which means it is holding three different arrays. And if I want to print the values, a is equal to 1 2 3 and 4 5 6 and 7 8 9. Okay, I am passing a for loop here for list one in a. Okay, what is the list one here in a, which means it is list one is going to a. What is the a value here? 1 2 3 block, as well as in 4 5 6 block, as well as in 7 8 9 block. Initially the, so instead of giving list one, we can also give another name. Suppose I am giving I. Okay, initially the I value will be 0, which means it is holding the 0th index position, 1 2 3. Okay, and comma 2 comma 3 for I in a. First of all, the I value select this particular array value 1 2 3, and if we print that particular b I value, so instruction, see, 1 2 3, it will print it successfully. Why it is printing 4 5 6 and 7 8 9 also? Because the loop will be getting terminated, because instead of getting terminated, the loop will get terminated. When the loop will be get terminated? After completing of each and every value in the variable what we stored. What is the variable what we are declaring here? A. So in the A, how many values are there? Three different type of values are there. This is the first array values, as well as this is the second array values, and this is the third array values. Okay, so in the first iteration, the I value will be selected 1 2 3, so 1 2 3 get printed successfully. In the second iteration, I is going to select the first index position. What is the first index position? 4 5 6. So 4 5 6 get is printed successfully. So at the second index position, 7 8 9, so it is printing 7 8 9 successfully. So if you just remove this particular value, see, what is the index for I in range of A? What is the first I value it is taking? The I value going to 1 2 3. First of all, it is going to 1 2 3, and we are printing that particular I. So 1 2 3 will be get it printed, and loop will be again repeated, because there are two values in the A. So A value will select 4 5 6 second time, and when we print 4 5 6, so 4 5 6 will be printed second time. So it will not print 7 8 9, because there is no option. We are not giving 7 8 9 values here. So the loop will be get terminated when completing of two repeated values. We execute it. See, 1 2 3, as well as in 4 5 6. So we just pass two values in the A category, which means in the A variable. So the loop will be terminated when it reaches the third position. The loop will be get repeated only at the two positions only. Okay, this is how the for loop get worked. So instead of writing for loop like this, so I am declaring a list here. So what is the list? We will see in the upcoming classes how the list get worked. So inside a list, I pass some values 1, 2, 3, 4, and I am writing a for loop for I in. If I just pass range of list, definitely it is going to show you some error. Suppose I am showing it practically. See, it is going to show some error. What is the type error? List object cannot be interpreted as an integer because we are passing an integer data structure, which means list is nothing but a built-in data structure. So instead of writing that particular values in the range function, we need to give directly the particular list value, list variable we need to give. So for I in list, so what is the I value here? So it will go to first value, it will take 1, and at the second iteration it will take 2, at the third iteration it will take 3, at the fourth iteration it will take 4. If you execute it, see 1, 2, 3, 4 get executed successfully. So whenever there is a built-in functions, which means list or string or tuple, set, dictionary, whenever there is built-in functions, range function will not work. So remember this. Okay, instead of writing list, we can also write a. So it is just a variable what we are storing the values. So at the first iteration, what will be the I value? 0. I is traveling from 0 and 1 and 2 and 3, so on, it gets repeated. So what is the, at the position of 0, I is equal to 0. What is the 0th index position? 1. So it is going to print 1. What is the first index position? 2. So it is going to print 2. So what is the second index position? 3. So it will print 3. What is the third index position? 4. At the third index position, the value 4 will be represented. So if I execute it, see, sorry, I am not commenting it. If I execute this particular cell, it executes successfully. Okay, so this is another best example. So instead of writing this variable number, I will just pass simple character for INA. See, we will see how the for loop is getting worked here. We have declared a variable a, and a is holding the values 1, 2, 3, this is the first array, and 4, 5, 6, it is second array, and 7, 8, 9, it is a third array. Okay, so this is the array representation, which means in the C and C++ and Java, we will return array representation in a different manner. In Java, it will be also in different format, but when in Python, we can easily represent that the array representation will be in, directly we can represent with the help of array keyword, or when we are declaring in the list, we will represent it with the help of two blocks, which means here we are representing three array, so we are writing three values. This is first array, and this is second array, as well as in this is third array. Okay, so a is equal to three values will be generated here. So for loop is generating from first index position to the last index position for I in a. Why we are not writing range function here? Because we are writing built-in function. This is list. There is no range function here. The range function will not be worked in this particular built-in functions. So it is a list. We are writing for I in A. Okay. What is the I value here? I value starts from 0. Index position. I value starts from 0. I is equal to 0. And 1, so 2, so 3, so it goes on till the when there is no values inside the particular list. When there is no values inside the list, it automatically get terminated. So for I in A, what is the I value? 0. So there is another for loop. Loop inside a loop. For J in I. So there is an J is equal to for J in I, which means what is the 0th position of the I? We will have a clear idea here. For I in A, what is the I starting position value? I is equal to 0. Okay. What is the 0th index position? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 are the values which is holding 0th index position. So we will see here. 1, 2, 3 are 0th index position values. for I in A, I is holding the 0th index position, the starting value. So 1, 2, 3, it is the 0th index position. So it is asking again loop for x in I. Okay, what is the I values here? 1, 2, 3. But what x is doing? It is going inside the I values. So x will be, what is the x values here? I values will, what is the I representation here? 1 comma 2 comma 3. But we are passing x also. X is going inside I. Okay, x is going inside I. So it is collecting one by one value. So x value will be 1, as well as in the second iteration, the x value will be 2, and in the third iteration, x value will be 3. So if you just print x, what will be the x value, starting value? 1, because 1 is in I array. Okay, so this is how the representation will be. If I execute it, see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 will be executed successfully. Okay, so at the 0th index position, it is collecting 1, 2, 3. Okay, so in this particular 1, 2, 3, we are passing another loop value, x variable. So x is collecting 1 as well as in 2 as well as in 3. So it is printing 1, 2, 3 here. So after completing of this first iteration, it is going to check another loop, which means I value will be 1. What is the first index position? 4, 5, 6. Okay, so I value will be, in the second iteration, the value will be 4, 5, 6. So from this 4, 5, 6, what the x is collecting? It is collecting one by one, 4 as well as in 5 as well as in 6. So the representation will be here, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so in the third iteration, the for loop is collecting the second index position. What is the second index position? This is the second index position, which means 7, 8, 9. So in the I, we will have now 7, 8, 9. Okay, 7, 8, 9. Okay, we are passing x inside the I. We are passing x inside I. What will be the x values now? X values will be 7, 8, 9. So see, at the third iteration, 7, 8, 9 will be printed successfully. So this is how the for loop get worked. In the first iteration, it is collecting 1, 2, 3. And in the second iteration, it will printing 4, 5, 6. And in the third iteration, it is printing 7, 8, 9. So if I write print here, so there is no problem. See, we'll have a clear idea when we pass print condition here. So at the first iteration, the I is collecting the 0th index position. So the 0th index position is 1, 2, 3. And x is collecting one by one value from the I values, 1, 2, 3. So at the first iteration, it is printing 1, 2, 3. And if the loop is repeating, because there are three values inside the list. So at the first index position, it is giving 1, 2, 3. And second iteration, it is printing 4, 5, 6. And third iteration, it is printing 7, 8, 9. If we pass another array here, suppose 3 comma 4 comma 5, see, there is another representation, because there are 4 values, the loop will be repeated 4 times. Okay, this is how the for loop get worked in the Python. The for loop can be worked with the help of range function if there is no built-in functions, built-in data structures. If we just passed built-in data structures, instead of giving range function, we can give directly that particular variable value. Okay, so this is how the for loop get worked. So in the next video, we will have a clear idea about the while loop and break condition and continue condition. Okay, so those who like this video, please subscribe to my channel and hit me a like button. In the next video, we will meet again. So thank you.